Welcome back to Let's Play Shadow Hearts 2. I'm actually re-recording this part because the last time I recorded it, see the timer, how it's almost 1:28. When I finished it, it was about 2:08. So let's go back to the Ardennes Forest. This time I do have a better idea where I'm going, so this is going to be a lot quicker than it was the first time. There's a couple treasures that I want to pick up. One of them is merely just to have it, because I want it. It'll save me some money in the short run. Also, I'll make money killing stuff, but, yeah, this thing's not down. And we have to go the long way around. There's also another crest, I think. Did I not? There should be one more crest kicking around in the, forest somewhere. And I missed that. So, ergo, I'm going to go look for it. Of course, I have to find it. I do have a better idea where I'm going, but still, this area is pretty big, and everything looks the same. Here's a chest that I went right by for soul benediction. Again, these things are not going to be huge, but they're free. All I gotta do is go out and find them. And I think these little bits and pieces, the fighting, has gotten to the point where I can just not show them unless something strange happens. I mean, yeah, that sounds right, doesn't it? Oh, I thought of something to tell you in that fight. Now I can't remember. I did check this, right? Yeah, there's nothing down here anyway, I don't think. Well, I think there was. Yeah, I got it, though, so it doesn't matter. What I'm actually doing is making my way back to the entrance. Well, where we started this little area. Isn't there a secret? Oh, is this it? Yeah, a Theraleaf. Again, not huge, but let me cross this stuff off. Alright. Yeah, I'm not going to show the fights unless something interesting happens. Thus far, nothing has. So, if the characters say something funny, or some random foolishness happens, I'll show that. Wasn't this the, yeah, this is dead end, this doesn't have anything in it. But I'm, nah.
If that's all they've got, no problem.
Ah, an extra Theraleaf, awesome. But yes, we're heading back to the cave. I'm going to use the tent and the save point. I don't have many tents left, but, nah, it doesn't matter. Just to make this little bit, the other half of the forest easy, I suppose. Because I'm getting a lot of enemies all clumped up together. And I would really like if I could use Gepetto and Blanca's MP to destroy something. Just saying. But yes, sanity points do recover after every battle. I didn't mention that, did I? This game would be really hard if it did. If it didn't. Wow. Anyways, moving on. I don't even remember what I was talking about. Not that it was going to be intelligent, funny, or otherwise. So, yeah. Is this... Oh, yeah. Chesty time. I chest... for a mana leaf. Yay. Alright, I forgot where I was on the map. Because I was inquisitive earlier. That looked like it would have been a secret path, but I guess not. I want to go to the right, I believe. If I'm following my map correctly, anyway. Which is entirely possible that I'm not. Ah, no damage in that fight, and I got a Theraleaf for it, so that's good. And the Barbados Crest. I don't know what this does, but I'm pretty sure it doesn't give us, healing abilities. Which is kind of crap. Crest change, Blanca, since you only have one, I might as well give you another one. Barbados, Air Edge, I think that adds air damage to... wind damage to someone's physical attack. There's a secret path right here. I'm not gonna take it, because I don't need to go that way. Is there anything up here? No, this has a secret path. Right here, doesn't it? Yeah. If we go south to right here is another chest. with a battery. No, if you remember the lift, which I do, considering I've done this twice. It's a good thing I'm not showing these combats, because I'm doing terribly. Oh, something else I could show you. If you go to library, and they do have the descriptions. Let's see, ducky toy, wooden lion. But the death snail, every time it grows, it needs to find a larger human skull for its shell. Yeah. And the skeeter is actually a plant incapable of photosynthesis, even though it's green and therefore has chlorophyll. Yeah. Wasp pupa infested by a parasitic snake. That's just weird. I mean, its tongue is a snake, and the wasp... I don't get it. I just don't get that monster at all. This is a pure leaf. More sanity points regeneration during combat. And... combat. Oh, you guys are screwed. I am so showing this. But yes, hail break. I should be able to hit all four if I can get it just right. Oh yeah, they're all dead. I'm showing this one. Yep. Four, once it comes up. No damage victory, Thera Leaf, two extra souls, so I get a Mana Leaf, a Thera Leaf, and now. That's what if... when you ambush someone, just hit him with a strong spell, even if you don't have that much. Chances are you'll get a Mana Leaf back, and blam, you'll recover your MP anyway. It's awesome. How many games give you bonuses for doing very well? Not many. A lot of RPGs, well, I guess it also takes some of the difficulty out of this game, and I guess that can be seen as something negative. But being, you know, my first time going to be playing through this game and beating it eventually, hopefully, it's quite helpful.
Stay out of my way.
More stuff. Anyways, moving on. Right over here should be the lift, but in this wall, right where the sign is, there's another soul benediction. Now, this is the hard part, where there are two more items in this area to get. We got Barbados, which was the important part, getting that last crest. But there's one more thing that is nice to have. You don't need it, but it will save you a little bit of money, I suppose. Ride the lift, okay, going down. Now, here's the part where it would be like, oh, it's, you know, you don't think to do this, but if you go back in the lift, you press it as low as you can go, so you're like, oh, okay, I'm done. But if you go back again, ride the lift, you can go to the top level. There's three levels, the top one being, you know, secret. This is very short, it's just two hidden treasures. One, right over here, which is a tent, I believe, yes. And the one that's hidden in this little cave, which is a leather cap. Leather cap being an accessory, blam, it gives you, like, two defense. I think Yuri's the only one who can equip it. Gepetto and Blanca both have it. It's kind of funny visualizing a wolf wearing a leather cap, though. I'd like to see art on that. It'd be kind of be silly, but it's two physical defense, which he really doesn't need. But, you know... I suppose when you have 23 defense, or whatever it was, and you get an extra 2, that's almost a 10% bonus, so you can't really complain about that. We should have enough souls to go into Yuri's graveyard again. And I think what I'm going to do is... well, I have the wind one. What I think I should do is go pick up the... fire one, which is really good for physical combat from what I've played with it. So we'll pick up this. And then the next one, I don't know what I'll pick up. I guess I could go pick up the water one. I don't think the water one actually comes with healing spells, but eventually you can unlock them, I think. I believe. I don't know, but I'm guessing. Maybe it's the light one. Yeah. Carol's soul. Again. Can I show that? Personal. Fusion. Carol. Turns into heavy. His strength. All his stats go up and blah, blah, blah. Skill list. Rage. Increases one ally's physical attack. And Blaze, which is amazing for bosses and whatnot. Especially if they're weak versus fire, obviously. I think after you unlock them in the graveyard, you don't actually have to run all the way to the stone either, which is rather nice. So let's go get the light one. Just because. I'd rather get them all unlocked and then worry about leveling them up later than to level up one really high and then have to start over with the other ones. Granted, we're going to be getting souls along the way, but I'd rather have Yuri have the capability of going, oh, hey, I have all these elements available to me and I'm set for any combat that comes up. It makes sense, you know? Having him slightly... This is the graveyard. Yes, it is. Alright, so I got those three. I do have the... this is the wind down here. I have the fire. I have the light one. And the other side has water... darkness and what? Earth? Yeah, Earth. Alright. Earth doesn't seem like it would be on the hell side, though, does it? Then again, how can you really divide elements up like that? I don't know. But anyway, that's all we wanted to do here, just get those items. It took me 11, 12, well, by my timer, it's like 12 minutes. But then again, I'm going to include one of the fights that weren't on the timer, so, nah. I'm going to save over that file, 205, which was the first time I completed it. And now that I know everything better, I finished at 148. So, I saved you some time, and we can actually probably fit in the cutscene in Paris. Yeah, let's go into Paris. Might as well get it done, and have some actual story progress in the episode. Why are we in... Oh, alright. It's Jean, or Jean. I think it's Jean, as far as his pronunciation went. But she is in Yuri's soul for some reason. Yay! Yeah, she is dead. When I first played through this little section, it was like, oh, that's terrible. I thought we were going to end up, you know, saving her from the bald guy or whatnot, but it was like, oh, she's dead. Crap. But it's too late for that. And for some reason, she is hanging out in Yuri's soul for whatever reason. I probably shouldn't have done this scene, but whatever. It's probably going to come out to like 25 minutes, but nah, that's fine. But she's looking for something in Yuri's soul, for whatever reason. Or inside her heart, his heart. Same difference. Don't go digging up anything embarrassing. Oh, she won't even tell him. Yuri, can you charge her rent? Just a thought. Although I don't know how you'd charge a ghost rent. Scared of the journey that's about to begin. What? Oh, yeah, because of, what's her name who died? Did it mention her name? I don't remember her name off the top of my head. But, I don't think it really matters which one you, pick. It doesn't change the conversation too much. And she poofs. Doesn't even give you the opportunity to look at stuff in his soul, either. Yeah.
Well, have you learned anything?
The mistletoe is a powerful item. The church has used it for centuries. As a tool for guiding lost souls. Well, that's what it says here anyway. It's now being kept at the Vatican.
So it's gonna guide my soul too?
I suppose so.
That's bull.
It is not bull.
Is there some way to fix it? Well, you've got to do something.
I think you're screwed.
Oh, ow, stop, let go.
You old man. Look at
whoa. Oh, Geppetto's an old pervert, and Yuri's a young pervert, I guess. But, yeah, it does make sense that she's taken off her German uniform. I mean, we're in Paris. It's not exactly a good place to be walking around with, iron crosses all over. Probably a bad idea. All I could see was stars. Oh, that's all? You saw something different? What'd you see? Paradise, my friend. Paradise. I think Geppetto needs new glasses. Also, I suppose that's... The real big problem I have with her new outfit is the whole arm thing. Like, the stocking on her arm. It looks so stupid. If you're gonna have it on both arms, please. No one's going to walk around with one stocking on an arm. They're going to put it on both arms. I don't know. At least be symmetrical. Anyways, I'm talking about her clothing, and they're talking about Yuri's mistletoe issue. This old fart. Go ask an even older fart. Old creature I know living in Wales. This guy's really, really old. Been alive for centuries. Wow. Is he human? Roger Bacon. That's a terrible name. I could not take a magician seriously if his name was Roger Bacon. I'm sorry, I just couldn't. Yep, we're going to the UK. Too bad there's a war being fought, and it's going to take some effort to get there. Port town, there's front line, blah blah blah, ship there. Yeah, so they're going away from the front lines to try to get a ship, which does make sense. Since, the port in the front lines is going to be rather occupied. Yeah. Nikolai was kind of a jerk. And her people would probably find her and kill her for whatever reason. But, so she's coming with us. And having Karin in our team is going to be a huge help. Because that brings us up to our four... maximum in a party at a time? And yes.
I hope you don't mind.
That's from my university days.
I found it over there. Is it all right if I borrow it?
He's not gonna say no.
You're welcome to it, my dear. They chased us all the way here? Sure are stubborn.
This is Geppetto's apartment, you jerks. If you're gonna jump in the window, at least jump all in the same window and not have to break all of them. Okay. This fight is going to be extremely easy. Why? They're all nice and close together. Oh, crap. I could've got her perfect with that. This is gonna kill all three of them. Or at least it should. Yeah. Blam. Done. I do get a no-damage victory, though, so, nah. I guess I can't have it all, and Karin's a little bit behind, but that's not a huge deal. She didn't do anything, it was the wolf! Ugh. Go to the storyline. Let me give you this. Now this is important, it's a script. Famous blah blah blah. There is a scene that could be very helpful to polish up your sword techniques. Now, this doesn't really make sense as far as the real world goes, but this is extremely nice. By picking up things like scenes or acts and plays or whatever, she learns new abilities with her sword. In this case, that. It's a fire technique, which does a small radius. As you pick up more, they'll become either more powerful or she'll get new ones, as it says there. She's fire-based, and she just got a fire skill, so, you know, stuff like that happens. The entrance to the subway, so we're going underground. Yay. Mr. Somenlier? I think that is another crest that we just picked up that it forced onto us. I think that one, though. At least I'm... Okay, maybe it's not. It's not in that either. I want to remove that, and I'm going to give it to Karin since her AC, her physical defense is a little bit lower than everybody else's. Well, lower than Yuri's at least, and they can't put on another one. So, that makes sense. Oh, boy. Where the hell was that item? Inventory. I will find it. Stud card collection number one. Yeah, you'll find out what that is. Yeah. That is important. That's extremely important, actually. We are going to need those, and we're going to need to pick up as many of those as possible. Well, we're going to pick all the ones up in the game. Well, if I find them all. Press change, Geppetto. I think this... Yep, this one's cure. And we're obviously going to give it to Geppetto, him having 71 MP, and everybody else is lower than 55. So... I believe there's one or two more items in this little apartment of Geppetto's, one being right here. Actually, I think this is it. I'm at like 25 minutes anyway, I really need to stop. But, next time, we will leave Geppetto's apartment and go into the subway that we keep hearing about. Well, we heard about. So until next time, this is RPG Looney. Signing off. And everything seems to have been recorded correctly. Yay! But yes, until then.